Welcome back to Smith's Studying. Today, we are coming to you to share this exciting, fun plant. If your kids are not in the room, you want to get them, pause the video because this is a really, really fun plant. We have really, really enjoyed this plant. This plant is called the TickleMe Plant. I purchased this book for Kaylee, for any of you that know us, and we have had so much fun with this plant, learning all about this plant and the different things that it does. So right off, I'll just show you this really cool thing to keep your attention. If you touch the plant, let me get a close up so you can see. If you touch the plant, it closes up. That's why it's called a Tickle Me Plant. How it closes up. It closes up. Isn't that neat? And just some fun facts about this plant. It is a sensitive plant that moves when you touch it. That's why it's called a Tickle Me Plant. And it's a real plant. And you might laugh, but some people have asked. It's a real plant. It requires food and water and soil and air and light and proper space to grow. And depending on how much space you give it will depend on how tall it will grow. It can grow 3 to even the tallest one is like 5 feet tall. Now, one of the things that you have to be careful about that we didn't realize is that there are thorns on them. So you only want to reach like and tickle like the green part of it. See how that closes up as soon as you tickle it? Isn't that neat? I'm gonna do some more. And you can even like, there's different ways you can tickle it. You can tickle it at the bottom and just make the bottom part fold up. See that? Where it's only part of it. And then we can just keep working our way back and keep doing more. Isn't that neat? Or you can just do a whole bunch and just have a lot of fun. Isn't that neat? So this plant is native to the tropical regions of like South and Central America. And it's also known as the shy plant. So you can get your seeds, you can order them. I order them online and you can get them on YouTube or Google it, Tickle Me Plant Seeds. And when you plant them, you wanna plant the seeds no deeper than 1/8 of an inch under the soil. And it's like the easiest plant to grow and keep alive. It can get a lot of water, a little bit of water. You don't want it to sit in water because it would rot, but it has been like one of the easiest plants to grow. If you want your seeds to grow even faster, you can boil hot water. Make sure that it's only you doing this, not kids. Boil the water, put the seeds in it, and let the seeds sit in room temperature at least 7 degrees or higher for a few days, and then go ahead and plant them in your soil, and they will take off even faster. So some of the other things that are fun about this, Kaylee, what is exciting to you about this plant? Like what was the funnest part for you?
Probably watching how big like it got. I didn't think that. I only thought there'd be a few and how it moves. It's
really cool. So you didn't think that it would grow that fast and we would get that many?
Super fast.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. So you can go.
And like when it died one time, it came back to life when you just watered it.
It did. It's like I would call it a sensory plant because it's so satisfying. You know, when you touch it and it closes up, and it takes about 15 minutes for it to open back up. It really depends on, it could take 15 minutes to an hour for it to open back up, but it really also depends on the health of the plant. If it's really healthy, it'll open back up sooner. At night, it actually goes to sleep. And I think it's probably the change in the temperature. But yeah, it's pretty neat. So we wanted to share this plant with you guys today and just encourage you to go and do this yourself with your kids. If you're a teacher, please pass this video on to teachers. What a great project to do with your kids. Now, each one of these, this is neat. This is what makes me think that this would be a great classroom plant, is that each one of these, like right here in this section, you'll see that there's four. One, two, three, four. You would think that these are individual. It's an individual leaves, but they're actually not. These are, it's actually called a compound leaf. It's one piece, but they all look individual. And see, when you touch it too, like the leaves drop. See how it dropped? Like when you touch it, like watch. See how, did you see how it drop? How it drops? It's so neat. Let's do this one. So the leaves close up and the leaves drop. Let's see if we can find another one. Let's see. And it does, it blooms really pretty flowers too. Let me see if I can find a picture of the flowers for you so you can see. Let's see if you can see this. Can you see the pretty purple flowers that it blooms? And the flowers only last like 24 hours, but it'll continue to bloom flowers over and over and over again. Not every single day, usually just in the fall. I mean, like one flower will come out, then that one will die, and then another one will pop up. That's what I mean. So usually if you plant the plant in the spring, usually by the fall, depending on weather conditions and stuff, it will bloom these pretty purple flowers. Hopefully you can see that. So if you have any questions or you would like to know additional information about this Tickle Me plant, please post your questions down below, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and if you hit the bell button also, you will get alerts every time we post a new video. Oh, and one of the other great things about this plant is it really doesn't matter what kind of soil that you plant it in. It will pretty much survive in anything. So I hope that you enjoyed this. And we will be posting our soap video very soon, so please be watching that. Thank you. Have a blessed day.